mic.
I just have a few questions and then a few suggestions. One is that in Karnataka, where we're working, the knowledge of 436 or 436A is really minimal. So when you file an RTI, to find out number of contracts or other, either of these sections, 436 being available and 436A, you don't get any information. You get random information with whoever they think fits the criteria with who generally do. And so one of my things, because records seem to be kept very poorly and softwares in general don't work, I'm thinking if there's some way, and I know CHRI has been working on a data management system with citizens, so if there's some way that records can be kept in a more systematic way, so accessing it as a human rights activist becomes an easier. The other, while we were doing some research, there was some looking at other jurisprudence and we're looking at areas where they've looked at bail and they've looked at alternatives to having financial bail, and one of them was the Manhattan Bail Project that they looked at, which then informed the Bail Reform Act in the US. And they did a 1 year long study where they looked at how judges award bail, whether there was an objective way of assessing, pre-trial assessment, whether the undertrials had society ties, ties to society, whether there were familial ties that you could actually track them. And therefore, and use that as a basis to award bail, not fines, not award bail in terms of monetary bail. So I think that was one area which would be interesting to look at. And I don't know if there's been a study on how judges award bail and whether they actually follow the criteria listed in the Hussein al-Kathoulou case, that there's 8 or 9 criteria. But if we can actually come up with a more objective way and with, talking with the